Hi! In this lecture, we will go over how to use the CVAT CLI. Let's talk about why you would use the CLI. If you want quick access to the server API without using the UI, if you want to automate your work, or if you want access to the functions beyond what the UI supports, the CLI is a great choice. The CVAT CLI allows you to do high-level operations with the server, send requests and responses without writing any code, and build automated pipelines integrated with other tools. It provides you with the most useful commands and comes with a great online documentation. Installing it is easy. The official releases for the tools are available in the standard Python package repository. To install the latest package, just run pip install cvat-cli. We recommend installing the tool inside its own dedicated Python virtual environment to make the installation independent from everything else. The tool is platform independent, meaning you can use it on all the most popular platforms. For example, Windows, Mac, and Linux. Once it's installed, you can run cvat-cli-help to see inline documentation. Or if you prefer to read it in a browser, follow the link at the bottom. I'll give a demo shortly, but here's a quick overview of the CLI's design. You have your commands to manage tasks and data, such as create, list, upload, and download. Many of these commands have optional arguments for users that need extra configuration. For example, specifying a different server address, port, or user credentials. To launch a command, you need to enter the tool name in a terminal or console, add general parameters, and then specify the command name and its specific parameters. Let's see a few examples. The first example is creating a task with a few images and uploading it to the server. This is similar in spirit to the REST API. We use our credentials and call create with the required parameters. In this case, it's the labels, the task name, and the images we want to use. In the next example, we request a list of tasks from the server. In the last example, we download a dataset for a task. In this case, we specify that we want the annotations to be in COCO format. By default, the tool works with the official server at app.cvat.ai. But you can specify your own server instance using the execution parameters if needed. There are also other useful parameters you can read about in the documentation. Here's a CLI usage demonstration. First, I'll show the current state of my account on my local server. To connect to my server, I will need to specify its location using the server host and server port parameters. Then, I'll use the list command to print the list of available tasks. We can see that we have a single task. The output is pretty simple, but it can be extended if we specify the JSON parameter. Now, we can get a lot more information presented in the JSON format. We can save it to a file or use other tools such as JQ to process the output automatically. Now, we will try to create a task. We'll use the create command. This command has a lot of parameters, which we would otherwise type in the browser fields if we were using the UI. The parameters are basically the same, but they offer more control over the command behavior. We'll just use a minimal set of parameters to create the task. We will see how the task is created and a progress bar indicating the status. Once we see that the task has been uploaded to the server, we can check the browser and confirm that the task was created. We can make sure that it includes the two images we specified and that it's available for annotation. Now, we will get another list of tasks on the server. We enter our credentials and run the command. Now, we will see a list of tasks available. Here, there are two tasks, including the one we just created. We can also see these tasks as JSON objects that include information that matches the Swagger API. Also, we can see that our new task has an ID that we can use to export annotations. Let's try exporting some annotations. After a few seconds, we get our downloaded dataset. Here, we can see it in the directory. We can also see that it includes annotations and is in the COCO format as requested. For your homework, I suggest you play with the CVAT CLI. You can use our server at app.cvat.ai or make your own. Try creating a task, getting a list of your existing tasks, and exporting one of the tasks as a dataset. If you need help, check out the documentation at the link on the bottom of this slide. I hope you found this video helpful. Thanks for watching.